Alright, I heard that GC2 doesn't read short chips very well, so I'm going to put it to the test. See if we can get it to register here. I think it registers things just fine, but it's a little bit of a green. A lot of energy, a lot of stamina. 26 feet, not as close as I'd like to be, but I can always just hit them short. But let's try to make it first.
14-16 hour days, and the staff is just spent after a while, and you're just like, man, when are we going to the hotel? When are we going down? You know, because you have all the issues of different time zones and things of that nature, too. And I'll tell you, out of everybody there, the president had more stamina and more energy than just about anybody there. He was the one that was always like, we're not going to skip this event, we're not going to skip this, we're going to do this, we're going to do that, and stuck to the schedule despite the urging of some of us to let's just forget the rest of the day.
How a guy who eats McDonald's for breakfast and all his Diet Cokes and who never exercises is in as good a shape as you say he's in.
It's called genetics. I don't know. It's some people have just great genes. You know, I told the president that if he had a healthier diet over the last 20 years, he might live to be 200 years old. I don't know. I mean, he has incredible genes. I would just assume. I mean, you know, if I didn't watch what I ate, I wouldn't have
any
He's very healthy despite those things, and I don't think that he does that anymore. I mean, you know, I mean, he's in the White House now. He's eating what the chefs are cooking for him now. They're cooking a much healthier diet for him now. And we're going to continue to work on that and make that even healthier.
Right, well,
but I would say the answer to your question is he has incredibly good genes. And
it's
just
short, we can get it to register.
You mentioned that you gave the president mental state examination or the Pulse test, or if not, can you tell us what specific cognitive test you did?
It was the Montreal Cognitive Assessment, sometimes for
purposes.
And you can find it online.
Do you have a life expectancy range for him based on his results? Number two, what exactly does the exercise and eating plan look like? Is it your elliptical machine next to the bedroom and the music? What does that look like? And then also number three, did you see the evidence of bone spurs, which the president
half as short as I would ever need to chip, but
none of that stuff's been bothering him recently, so we didn't examine his for bone spurs right now. He's not come to me, complaining of that, so there was no reason in this particular assessment. We were pretty crunched for time with everything we had done, so we didn't look at any issues like that, so I didn't assess that, no. As far as life expectancy, I'll say he probably won't live to be 200, but I don't know, I think his life expectancy is, I would just like to say it's the same as every other American male right now, but it's certainly no less.
And then is it the dietary and exercise plan? What's in store?
We're working it out right now. Actually, what I'm doing is one of the things is I'm getting a nutrition specialist to come up here and meet with the chefs that we have here, and they're going to go over the preparation of the president's food just to make sure that we're, cutting the calories and the fats and the carbohydrates as much as we possibly can and still making, good meals for him. With regards to the exercise, that's something that myself and, potentially Mrs. Trump will work with him upstairs. Right. There's a gym upstairs, and we'll get set up to his specifications, and we'll see how that goes.
Is he limited to one strip of ice cream now?
I don't make recommendations.
That he's taking that you're not permitted to tell us. Is there anything you're keeping from us for privacy reasons?
I can promise you there's absolutely nothing that I'm withholding from this. And I can tell you that, I've done the last...